Hey Townelake, my name is Brandon Schultz and I'm here at the Christmas Angel Warehouse where a little over 900 kids are going to get a Christmas and these are all their gifts. We're privy to the moments leading up to the madness. I hear it gets pretty insane in here. We have an interview with Sherri Walker, who's kind of the boss of this whole operation. So we're going to see that and we're going to see the drivers and all the craziness that goes into this. So I hope you guys kind of get a sneak peek into what goes into the Christmas Angel program.
The greatest day in history. Death is beaten, you have rescued me. Sing it out. Jesus is alive. Empty cross and empty grave. Life eternal, you have won the day. Shout it out, Jesus is alive.
I don't know if you can see that on my jacket, but that would be snow. The Christmas Angel warehouse workers are working in the freezing cold while it's snowing, thus proving that you have to be a little bit crazy to be a warehouse worker for the Christmas Angels. All right, so Sherri Walker, you're the Christmas Angel head honcho, is that correct?
I guess so. I have a big team of women that help me.
All right, what kind of goes into the team?
Okay, so we have a team of volunteers. We start with the school counselors giving us the children, and they go to our wish list group. They get all the kids' sizes and their needs and a couple wants, and then from the wish list, it goes to data entry and to the adoption coordinator who adopts the children out to the families in our congregation at Hillside United Methodist Church and people around the community. And once the children are shopped for, it comes to the warehouse. And then this is the grand finale of delivery day today.
How many kids do you have this year?
953, which is about 200 more than Hillside's done before.
Okay, so these are kids that otherwise would not have a Christmas.
They would have no Christmas. And we use a system called Charity Tracker so that we can work with our fellow churches in the area to make sure that each family is being helped only one time.
Okay, so how do these kids, how do you screen these kids?
They come through the school counselors. So the school counselors in our area, since we have such great schools, they know these kids personally, and they hand select them so that we do know that they're in need.
All right, so how early do you have to start planning all this?
Oh, goodness. We start late September, and we finish up today, and of course there'll be cleanup and final things throughout this week.